Guys, this is my review of F1 testing. The first 4 days of testing are over. They go quickly once it starts. And yeah, we've got testing next week. So yeah, well, let's get started. Obviously, Ferrari didn't mess about with the pace they had. Came straight out with Vettel and did, I think it was 165 laps with Vettel on the first day. And clearly showing to the rest of the paddock that, yeah, we've got the pace and we are here to, we mean business. Mercedes took a more relaxed approach, which is what I was wondering and was thinking that they would do, like they've done in most tests before the season starts. Bottas and Hamilton taking it in turns on each in morning and afternoon. Ferrari decided to do one driver on one day. So yeah, it was nice to see Leclerc in the Ferrari. Notice the Ferrari colour was rather orange in the sunlight, rather than the scarlet red that we used to. I'm not keen on that, but there you go. But yeah, Mercedes then decided towards the end of the session to show their true pace, or give suggestions that they have got a pace. I didn't have any fears that they had the pace, they didn't have the pace. If they didn't think they have or knew they didn't have it, they would have probably suggested it. They were feeling confident all the way through. Red Bull looked right up there as well with Verstappen and Gasly. I was about to say Ricardo, but we all know he's gone to Renault. He had an interesting session with Ricardo. I'm not sure the development of the rear wings, the new development he created on the rear wing was mint. If you all saw the video of that, or saw the replay of that. Still think Renault are going to be a little bit off the rest of the field. One major story is Williams. They all need a really good test session this time round if they are going to make progress. And again, it came out obviously that the first 2 days they weren't going to be able to race. The only car they had there was a show car. It was an actual car that could go out and test. So yeah, that was disappointing on their part. And it is disappointing with them. They need it. They really do. After what happened last season, they need a strong test to be able to get on. Because if you can't get on the track, you can't gather the data. You can't work out what the pace is, and you can't work out what's wrong with the car to then be able to fix it. Simulation can only tell you so much. Nothing beats on-track testing out there. So you need to get on track and test. And if you're not going to do that, you're just going to be falling behind the rest of the field. So I'm hoping that they are at least mixing it up with the rest of the field. McLaren showed decent pace and reliability, even if at one point they did leave the garage and then stopped straight away. Has had their own little issues here and then. Had quite a few. They had one day three stop calls, three red flags at one point. So I hope that doesn't continue into the season. Otherwise, they're going to be struggling. Alfa Romeo, Raikkonen, it's different to see him in an Alfa, but they look like they've got the pace from what they had last year. So it looks like they've carried it on. So it looks like the wall changes in the wings and the end plates. Like I would think, because they're not going to be massive changes, they haven't really mixed up the grid. Because you know, like when 2014 came out, loads of people, Ferrari were thrown off the got off the wrong foot. Mercedes went from the third best team to the top team, and dominant team. 14, you got right up there mixing it up. So, yeah. These walls haven't really thrown everyone. their pace, usual pace from last year, which is good, especially if you're a Hamilton fan and you want him to be up the top. So yeah, it all is interesting, and I'm looking forward to next week and seeing hopefully a bit more pace from Mercedes, and just confirm that they have got the pace amongst Ferrari and they can beat him by a mile, hopefully. So yeah, it's all there to play for. And I would like to say one thing I do say about Williams and his help. It was nice to see Kubica back out there. I think it's incredible how he's had that accident, and after everyone thinking he'd never be back in the sport, being able to come back through his injuries. I mean, half of his hand still doesn't work properly, and the fact that he can still get in a car, get in an F1 car, and deliver the pace that he still has is an incredible story, and I hope he does well, and hope that he drives Williams on, because Williams, I think, last year missed an experienced driver that knew about the car, knew what they needed to develop it, which was why last season, halfway through it, I was wondering why they weren't putting Kubica in. So I'm hoping they can drive him forward along with George Russell, who I hope can give them the pace they need, because he's F2 champion of last season, so he's no slouch, especially if he's also in the Mercedes Driver Academy. So yeah, I did watch the video about Leclerc and the story between him and Jules Bianchi, which is quite an extraordinary story, especially since Leclerc is basically taken now what would have been Jules's seat. We all know that Jules would have made it into Ferrari after their statement after he died, which was tragic. I mean, throughout my life, I was born in 94, so I never saw, and that was after Senna's death, so I've never seen anyone die in Formula 1, and I knew of the risks from watching the history, but it was quite shocking and horrible to see that happen, and I was glad to see that the sports learned from that with the VSC and moved on. But I'm glad that I'm sure Bianchi would be very proud of Leclerc, especially since like he could get through like losing his father and still turn up the next day at Azerbaijan and win the F2 races. So yeah, an extraordinary story, and I hope he does well at Ferrari and succeeds and pushes Vettel on also. If he pushes Vettel on, Vettel will push Hamilton on, and Hamilton will just revel in that and try and push himself on. So yeah, the more competition, the better it's going to be, not just for the drivers, but not just for the teams, but for the fans in general, which is the most important thing, because the sport would be nowhere without the fans. And that's as simple as that. It's like we've been in Arsenal Football Club. As an Arsenal supporter, if I was in an Arsenal supporter and no one else around the world was an Arsenal supporter, Arsenal would be nowhere. So it's like with any sport, any club, your fans are the lifeblood of anything, because we pay the money, we pay so much to be there and pay so much interest. So, but yeah, I'm just rambling on now. So I'm going to leave it there, and we'll look forward to next week. Let me know what you think about the tests. Who do you think, Sean, and yeah, who do you hope is going to shine next week and shine when the season starts? Yeah, so leave a like, subscribe, and yeah, leave your comments below, and I'll speak to you soon.